And every organization should have a code of ethics. And here is why. First of all, let's give a definition. Okay. All right, first of all, let's look at a definition of code of ethics. And sometimes people use the word code of ethics and code of conduct interchangeably, but they are two different concepts. While a code of ethics can encompass a code of conduct, your code of ethics is more broad. It more closely resembles principles, while your code of ethics is more focused. It tells you exactly what is expected and what is not expected. Instead of giving you a definition, let me illustrate what I'm talking about. So when we look at, for example, this example of a code of ethics, we look at be inclusive, be considerate, be respectful, choose your words carefully, don't harass. These are some of the guiding principles that you would mostly find in a code of ethics. But you will notice they more sound like principles. They're not specific. So be respectful. Be respectful how? But of course, when we hear this, we know exactly what is meant by being respectful. But what your code of conduct does, your code of conduct gives you more specifics. For example, when you talk about the dress code, which would be a part of your code of conduct, that will specify what the dress code is. When it talks about cell phone usage, it will specify what's the company's policy when it comes to your cell phone conduct, what is expected of you. And so your code of conduct would be more detailed as opposed to your code of ethics. Now, like I said before, your code of conduct and your code of ethics can be one document. Your code of ethics could embed your code of conduct. It will also contain your core values and your organization's mission and vision, right? So know the distinction between your code of ethics and your code of conduct, and understand that sometimes the code of ethics can be embedded, the code of conduct can be embedded in your code of ethics as well. It addresses things like conflicts of interest and what is considered your conflict of interest. And it also addresses things like employee relations and visitors to the workplace. So we see the distinction between your code of ethics and your code of conduct, and your code of conduct is direct. There is no doubt. This is what the organization take is regarding this particular behavior.